Good afternoon, class. My name is Johnny.
And I'm John.
And today's topic is Tay-Sachs disease. Tay-Sachs disease falls under a monogenetic disorder. What a monogenetic disorder is a mutation in a single gene. A monogenetic disorder can fall under three different categories, which is dominant, recessive, and X-linked. Tay-Sachs disease falls under a recessive monogenetic disorder because it has to come from two parents. Background information about Tay-Sachs disease: it's a rare condition because it's a disease that is autosomal recessive, which means it can pass on from generation to generation without it showing up until years later. What Tay-Sachs disease actually is, it's a mutation that occurs in the neurons in our spinal cord and our brain cells. It's a hexagene makes a part of an enzyme called beta hexaminidases. And what that enzyme does, it helps break down GM2 ganglioside, which build up in our nerves. So if that enzyme is not created, a lot of neurons will build up, and that's what causes mental functions, behavioral problems, and seizures. So many neurons cause that. Like I said, it was a rare disease, and our thesis statement is Tay-Sachs disease is also known as a GM2 gangliosidosis and considered a rare inherited condition that affects nerve cells.
So some statistics for Tay-Sachs disease is 16 people are diagnosed with Tay-Sachs disease every year. And the two groups of people that are affected mostly by Tay-Sachs disease are Irish American and people of Jewish descent. 1 in 360,000 people per year have a chance of their offspring having Tay-Sachs disease and describing and showing general characteristics that are associated with Tay-Sachs disease. So Tay-Sachs disease is a very, very rare disease that only occurs in very few amount of people per year. And some symptoms of Tay-Sachs disease are muscular degeneration, vision and hearing loss. You also see a cherry spotted speckle, if you will, on the eye, and when you see that, you know that it could be Tay-Sachs disease. What happens is that most infants die by age 5 because Tay-Sachs disease is incurable. There's no treatment, but you can mitigate that situation and disease with proper nutrition and eating habits. And what happens later on when the children become, you know, teenagers or in their 20s, mid-adult life, is they have to be hooked up to a breathing tube where food will be transferred down into the breathing tube in order for nutrients to be proper absorbed into their body. And the conclusion of Tay-Sachs disease is Tay-Sachs disease is also known as GM2 gangliosidosis, and it is autosomal recessive disease that affects offsprings of the parents.